Hello, dear students. Today we are going to study one of the important points in the rotational dynamics, and the name of the concept is moment of inertia of a thin uniform ring. MR of a thin uniform ring about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to plane. Suppose this is a thin uniform ring. This is a thin uniform ring of mass capital M and radius capital R. Capital M is mass of the ring. Capital R is the radius of the ring. Let IC be the moment of inertia of this thin uniform ring about an axis passing through center and perpendicular to its plane. IC be the moment of inertia of this ring about an axis passing through center and perpendicular to plane. Okay? Suppose rho be the linear density of the ring. Rho is linear density of the ring. And we know that linear density is nothing but mass per unit length of the ring. Rho is mass per unit length of the ring. And we know that length of the ring is equal to circumference of the circle. Okay? Therefore, rho equal to m divided by 2 pi r. Mass per unit length of the ring, which is called linear density of the ring. Now suppose that this ring is made up of, this ring is made up of number of small elements. Number of small elements. Suppose this ring made up of number of small elements. And we have to consider one single element of the ring. We have to consider one single element of this ring. Suppose dm is the mass of single element. Dm is the mass of single element of the ring. And dx is length of the element. Dx is length of the element. Now, first of all, we have to calculate moment of inertia of this element. We have to calculate moment of inertia of this element. And then by integrating mr of a single element, by integrating mr of a single element, we get moment of inertia of the whole ring about an axis passing through center. Okay? Now, this mass of element dm, mass of this element dm is equal to mass per unit length of the ring, that is linear density of the ring, m divided by 2 pi r, into the mass of the single element of the ring dm is equal to mass per unit length of the ring, that is linear density of the ring, into length of the element, that is dx. Mass of element dm is equal to mass per unit length of the ring into length of the element. Okay? Now, we know that moment of inertia of this element dm about an axis passing through center is mass into distance square, that is dm into r square. Moment of inertia of element dm is equal to dm into r square. Dm into r square. Substituting the value of dm from above equation, we get moment of inertia of element dm is equal to value of dm is m divided by 2 pi r into dx into r square. Suppose this is equation number 1. This equation gives moment of inertia of the single element of the ring. Now we have to calculate moment of inertia of a whole ring about an axis passing through its center of mass. Therefore, moment of inertia of a ring about an axis passing through center of mass, that is IC, is obtained by integrating moment of inertia of such elements between limit 0 to 2 pi r. Between limits 0 to 2 pi r. Therefore, we are now operating IC above an axis passing through center of mass is obtained by integrating moment of inertia of the single element, that is m divided by 2 pi r into dx into r square between limits 0 to 2 pi r. 0 to 2 pi r. Therefore, IC is equal to integration limit 0 to 2 pi r. R square by R, R. Therefore, that is equal to MR divided by M into R square by R, R. MR divided by 2 pi into dx. Okay? This term, M is mass of the ring, which is constant. Capital R is radius of the ring, which is always constant. 2 pi is constant. Therefore, this equation we can write as IC equal to constant term taken outside the integration MR divided by 2 pi into integration of dx between limits 0 to 2 pi r. Okay? And we know that integration of dx is x. Integration of dx is x. Therefore, IC equal to MR divided by 2 pi integration of dx in x between limits 0 to 2 pi r. Okay? Now, we can take upper limit minus lower limit. This equation becomes IC equal to MR divided by 2 pi into upper limit 2 pi r minus lower limit 0. Okay? This 2 pi term gets cancelled. Therefore, we get the equation IC is equal to MR into R MR square. Very important expression. This is an expression for moment of inertia of a thin uniform ring about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its plane. Now, we know that the relation between moment of inertia and radius of gyration is I is equal to mk square. I is equal to mk square. Or, from this equation we can write k equal to under root I by m. We have already calculated value of moment of inertia of a ring about an axis passing through center. Therefore, radius of gyration k is equal to under root m r square divided by m. M in this cancel, k equal to root r square, and therefore k equal to r. Suppose this is equation number 3. This is the radius of gyration of a thin uniform ring about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to plane. Moment of inertia of a thin uniform ring about an axis passing through center and perpendicular to plane is mr square, and radius of gyration about an axis passing through center of mass of the ring is k equal to r. Okay. Hello, dear students. In last lecture, we have already discussed moment of inertia of a thin uniform ring. Moment of inertia of a thin uniform ring. Now, we are going to discuss another important point, that is moment of inertia of a thin uniform disk about an axis passing through its center of mass and perpendicular to plane. Suppose this is a thin uniform disk. This is a thin uniform disk. Capital R is radius of disk, m is mass of disk. Let capital M be the mass of the disk. Capital M be the mass of the disk. Capital R be the radius of the disk. Okay? Suppose that sigma is area density of the disk. Sigma is area density of the disk. Area density is nothing but mass per unit area of the disk. And we know that area of the disk same pi r square. Therefore, area density of the disk is equal to mass divided by area, that is equal to m divided by pi r square. M divided by pi r square is the area density of the disk. Now, suppose that, or we can imagine that this disk is made up of number of small elemental rings like this. This is a one single ring. This is one single ring of the disk. And we can imagine that this disk is made up of number of these rings. Number of rings. We can imagine that this disk is made up of number of thin uniform concentric rings like this. We can consider a one single ring, elemental ring of that disk. Suppose small r is the radius of the elemental ring. Small r is radius of that elemental ring. Okay? And dr is the thickness of that elemental ring. Okay? Capital M is mass of disk. Capital R radius of disk. We imagine that disk made up of number of uniform rings. We can consider one single elemental ring of radius small r, and dr is the thickness of the elemental ring. Okay? Now, we have to calculate moment of inertia of this disk about an axis passing through center and perpendicular to plane. For this, first of all, we have to calculate moment of inertia of this ring, elemental ring, and then by integrating mr of this ring between limit 0 to capital R, we get mr of a whole disk. Therefore, first of all, we are going to calculate moment of inertia of this elemental ring. For this, first of all, we have to calculate mass of the ring. Mass of ring. Okay? Mass of the ring is equal to mass per unit area. Mass per unit area of the disk into area of the into area of the ring. Mass of the ring is equal to mass per unit area of the disk m divided by pi r square into area of the ring. Okay? That is equal to m divided by pi r square, mass per unit area of the disk into area of the ring is nothing but circumference into thickness. Circumference into thickness. Circumference of the ring is 2 pi r into thickness is dr. Okay? This pi pi gets cancelled. Therefore, mass of the ring is 2m divided by capital R square into small r into dr. This is the mass of the single elemental ring. Mass of the single elemental ring, which is equal to mass per unit area into area of the ring. Mass per unit area into area of the ring. Mass per unit area is m divided by pi r square into area of the ring is circumference of the ring into its thickness 2 pi small r into dr. Pi pi gets cancelled. We get equation 2m divided by r square into small r into dr. Therefore, moment of inertia of a elemental ring about an axis passing through center of mass is nothing but, we have already calculated the formula, moment of inertia of the ring is mass into radius square. Here radius of the ring is small r, and mass of the ring we have already calculated, 2m by r square, small r into dr. 2m by capital R square, small r into dr, into radius square means small r square. Okay? that is equal to 2 m by r square into small r into r square r cube into dr. Suppose this is equation number 1. This equation gives moment of inertia of this single elemental ring about an axis passing through center of mass. Now we have to calculate moment of inertia of the whole disk. Moment of inertia of a whole disk about an axis passing through center of mass. And this moment of inertia of the whole disk can be obtained by integrating moment of inertia of the elemental ring between limits 0 to capital R. Between limits 0 to capital R. Therefore, moment of inertia of a disk about an axis passing through center of mass is given by IC is equal to integration of moment of inertia of a ring 2m divided by r square, capital R square, into small r cube into dr between limits 0 to capital R. Between limits 0 to capital R. Because this disk is made up of number of concentric rings. Okay? In this equation, this constant term 2m divided by capital R square. Mass of the disk is constant, radius of the disk is also constant. Constant term taken outside the integration, we get IC equal to 2m by R square into integration limits 0 to capital R, R cube into dr. Okay? Solve this integration. Integration of x raised to n, we know that formula integration of x raised to n is equal to x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Using this formula, we can calculate this integration r cube into dr. We get equation IC equal to 2 capital M divided by r square. X raised to n plus 1 means r raised to 3 plus 1, that is r raised to 4 divided by 4 between limits 0 to capital R. Therefore, IC equals to 2m divided by this 4 constant take outside the bracket 4 r square into bracket small r raised to 4 limit 0 to capital R. Okay? Therefore, we get equation IC equal to 2m divided by 4r square into bracket upper limit minus lower limit, that is capital R raised to 4 minus 0. Okay? Therefore, IC equal to m divided by 2r square into r raised to 4. R raised to 4 divided by r square is r square. Therefore, we get final equation as IC equal to mr square divided by 2. Very, very, very important equation. This is an expression for moment of inertia of a thin uniform disk about an axis passing through center of mass and perpendicular to its plane. Okay? Radius of direction is given by k is equal to under root I by m. Value of I is mr square by 2. Therefore, we get k is equal to under root m r square divided by 2 divided by m. Mm gets cancelled. K equal to root r square by 2 means k equal to r divided by root 2. For it is also written as r divided by root 2 is 1.414. This is the radius of gyration of the thin film disc about an axis passing through center and perpendicular to its